Greetings everyone. In this video, I am going to show you how you can use different kind of diffusers in your computer. As we know, we usually use a CKPT file released by the model trainers. But in this case, this Dreamboot avatar released by Lambda Labs doesn't have a CKPT file. It is like this, as you see. It has different type of files. So how can you run this in your computer? To running this in our computer, we are going to run this Python code. And I find that the most easiest way is using a Visual Studio Community Edition. Just type Google or your search engine Visual Studio Community Edition and you will get into this page. As you can see, I will put this link into the description. Click download. And when installing, what you need to be careful is selecting Python installation. If you are not sure how to install Visual Studio Community Edition, I have a video on that. Just go to our channel and in here click playlist and in here go to technology and science videos. And in this playlist, you will see at the 11th index currently how to debug your Python code properly by using Visual Studio Community 2022. In this video, I'm explaining how to install your Visual Studio, and once you have installed your Visual Studio with Python, we are ready. So type to your search bar as Visual Studio, you will get the program from AppStop here, Visual Studio 2022. Okay, this is the beginning screen of Visual Studio. I am going to click create new project. In here from templates, we need to select Python. So I am typing Python to the search bar. It may take a while for it to arrive. Okay, it has listed me Python as a Python application in the first case. This is the application type we need. Click next. Click define its name and your location as you wish. Click create. Okay, our Python application has been opened and I am just dragging it like this. So by default, it is going to use the Python version you have installed. If you have installed or during the initial installation, or you can alternatively install other Pythons as well. Currently we have Python 3.9, as you can see. Watching that video will help you greatly, by the way. Okay, authors of this model have explained how it is easier to use. However, there are some catchy things. You see, we are importing Torch, diffusers, and AutoCast libraries. To be able to use them, first we need to install Torch. And how we are going to install Torch? From this command, if you install, you are going to get error. First, we need to install PyTorch from its official website command, which is package pipe Python CUDA on 11.7. It is the latest version, and I'm copying this command. Then returning back to my application, in here I am right clicking my application name here, and I am opening command prompt here, and I am right clicking with right click to your mouse, or you can right click here and from here paste, pasting the command and clicking enter. This will install PyTorch with enabled Juda. Okay, therefore we will be able to use Juda enabled PyTorch. If you just go and install this command, it will not work. You will get an error, so you should follow my steps. I will put these links and commands into the description of the video, so don't worry about them. By the way, previously somehow if you have installed a PyTorch version but not with CUDA enable it, then you need to uninstall your Torch version, then you need to reinstall this one with CUDA enable it version. Okay, CUDA enable it version installation has been done, you see, because we have selected CUDA, not CPU. And as I said, if you have previously installed PyTorch somehow, you just need to call pip tree uninstall torch. You may need to run this command twice, then just copy and paste this command and run it, and it will install. Now let's return back to our model. Now we need to install diffusers. I am copying the diffusers from here, going back to my command window, and I am typing pip install diffusers. It is going to install diffusers. It shouldn't take long. Then I am copying this code here completely, and I am pasting it into my project. Okay, I have pasted into my project. Now just you need to click start button and it will click and generate images in the style you want. Okay, let's see. Also, it will download the necessary files first. Oh, it says that we are still missing a library, transforms library. Let's also install it. It is so easy. Just pip install transformers. Okay. Okay, installation of transformers also has been completed. Okay, one final thing is left. We also need to pip install accelerate. Now I'm going to do that. To do that, now we can safely copy this command here and run it because we have installed two other necessary things. Okay, I have copy pasted it. Now it will install other necessary stuff and then we will be ready. Okay, it has been done. Let's click F5. F5 means running it. You can also click the start button. Okay, now we will see that it is going to download necessary files into our cache folder. And then we are going to get this prompt run, and then we will see the saved outputs images in the folder where it will be inside our application folder. To go there, right click Python application, and in here open folder file in Explorer. So they will be saved here. Let's see what's happening so far. Okay, it has started downloading the necessary model files and other things into cache. Once they are cached, they won't be re-downloaded again, so don't worry about that. Currently downloading the biggest file, the model file. I think it is inside files and versions. In here, it is inside, let's see. Yes, inside UNet, you see diffusion PyTorch model.bin file. Okay, so our code has been run and the images has been generated. You see there are four images because we have made the samples four. Let's see them with large icons or extra large icons. Okay, you see these are the images. They are saved with this numbering format, as you can see. So let's change our input to something else. Okay, I'm changing the input as photo of Keanu Reeves avatar style. The avatar is the keyword that they use to train their model. I'm going to generate 10 samples. By the way, currently it is using my graphic card because you see we are converting them to GPU. Now to execute it, I'm just going to restart the application. And now we will see that it is not going to re-download the files. Let's also check out the GPU usage. Meanwhile, it is generating artworks. Okay, let's see. By the way, it doesn't show any progress or something. You see the VRAM usage because it is the VRAM right now. Okay, I did get a GPU error because I have increased the number to 10, and since I already have some other applications open, my 12 gigabyte GPU VRAM was not enough. I am going to therefore reduce samples to 4 back again. If you can't stop the application, just forcibly close your project and restart. Oh, it just did. Okay, currently I am getting 4 new images of the photo of Keanu Reeves. You see it is displaying progress actually right now. Okay, the images have been generated like this. It has overridden the previous files because it is starting from zero. Okay everyone, now I am going to show you how you can convert this model into a CKPT file, and from the CKPT file that you can train your own face or other things and use it in the web UI, as we have shown numerous times in our channel, in our playlist. Let me show you. You already maybe know, but in our Stable Diffusion Dreamboot playlist, we are always using CKPT file. So how are we going to convert this into a CKPT file? First, we need to download entire repository into our drive. To do that, we are going to use git bash. So if you wonder what is git bash, just type git bash into Google. It's a free open source software, and then run it after installing it like this. Okay, then let me zoom in a little bit. Go to your move to your C drive with CD C and like this. Now we are in the C drive, then type git clone, okay, and in here copy this URL like this and paste it into here. So it will clone entire directory into the C drive. Currently I am doing that. It is taking a lot of time and it is not showing what is happening. You see currently it is downloading the big files with 100 megabits per second. This is my speed. And let me show you, when I enter the directory that it is copying, you can see they are getting downloaded right now. Okay, the first binary file were downloaded. Now it is downloading the other ones. Once this is done, we can move to the next step to convert our to generate our CKPT file. Okay, all of the files have been downloaded. You see, it is done, and now waiting our new command. Let's go to our folder and check them out. In the via folder, yes, we see binary file. In the unit, we see as well. So the next step. For the next step, we need convert diffusers to original stable diffusion PI file. And if you wonder where to find it, you can just type into the Google like this. And it first open the Google here, and then type it, and you will get the link of it. I will also put this link into the description of our video. So how are you going to download it? To download it, click RAW. It will open the RAW file, then right click and click save as. So I am going to save it into my downloads folder, then I will copy and paste it. By the way, we are going to save it as PI file, not the TXT file. So I am going to download it like this. Okay, it has been downloaded. Let's click show in folder, right click, copy it, then open our project file in here, right click, open a folder in file explorer, and paste it here. Okay, we are ready. Now we need to set our folder names. So the folder of our Dreamboot avatar is here. I am clicking here to copy its path like this. Then let's give the folder path. Don't worry, I will also put this command into the description of the video. Then the checkpoint path, I am going to output it into my Python application folder. So I am opening once again here. I am copying it like this. Then let's paste it like this. And in here, let's define a path. Let's say Dreamboot avatar. Okay, like this .cpt file. Okay, now how we are going to run this command? We are going to run this command by copy the command like this, copy, then come right click our project, and in here open a command prompt here, right click and click enter. Now it is supposed to generate the CKPT file. Okay, you see it has started processing. And it is done. It was really quick. Let's check out whether it was generated or not. So right click our project, open a folder in Explorer, and in here let's see if our CKPT file, yes, our CKPT file is in here, Dreamboot avatar CKPT file. Okay, since it is 1.5 version based, we don't need a special YAML file for it. So I'm going to cut this and paste it into our stable diffusion. Okay, in here, Stable Diffusion Web UI, in here we have, as you know, models, and in here we have Stable Diffusion, pasting it here. Then I am running my web UI to see whether it is working or not. Okay, we have started our web UI. By the way, I was using several text embeddings, so I'm going to remove them. They are inside embeddings folder. I'm going to delete them to not affect our results. Then I'm going to load to our new model, which is Dreamboot avatar CKPT. Okay, it is getting loaded. And then let's type our command with which was this one. Okay, we have an error. Let's see the error. Even though we generated CKPT file. Okay, let's see. Okay, looks like we have a shape error. Yeah, we need to fix this probably. Okay, I have solved the problem. It was a very weird solution actually. So even though the model owner said that they have trained it on version 1.5, I thought that maybe they were using version 2.1 YAML file. So I tried the version 2.1 YAML file in the model folder. However, it wasn't producing any images. Then I have compared version 2.1 and 1.5 YAML files. Then I started deleting the differences. After I have deleted parameterization YAML file from the YAML file of 2.1, it started working. As you can see now, I am able to use this new model file that we have generated, remote-avatar.cqpt. So let's say you want to teach your faces into this model. What you need to do is just go to the Remboot tab, generate your model, and as a source checkpoint, select your Remboot avatar CKPT file and give it a name, and the rest is same. Hopefully I will also upload a new video about full Remboot training, and it will be available on our channel playlist. It will be available in this playlist. If you don't know how to use them, you can also watch these playlist videos. I also have opened bug reports in the diffuser GitHub, and also in the Stable Diffusion web UI. So hopefully this bug will be fixed maybe in very soon. So also this model, this error could be only related to this model. Therefore, I think you may not encounter such error. So this is the YAML file that I have generated. Let me show you. So you see, this is the Remboot avatar CKPT file, and this is the YAML file that I have generated. I will also put this YAML file into the description of the video, so you will be able to use this if you want to use this particular model. And if you have any questions, just join our GitHub page and ask me any questions there. Let me show you our GitHub page link. So our GitHub page is existing on our About page. I mean our Discord channel. Sorry about that. So you can join our Discord channel from this link, clicking there, and you can ask me any questions you want. Please like, subscribe, and share our videos. And if you support us on Patreon, we would appreciate that very much. So far we have only one patrons, but I am hoping that you will be our next patron. So feel free to ask any questions through comments or from Discord. Hopefully see you in another video.